Our truce begins. Have you met any Flark shippers in all your years of cons?
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean,
I guess it's easy for me to say that.
Quite some time ago. Yeah. They're out there, though.
Who made that video?
A food fan. So they sourced, and some people did cut together like certain character moments. I think they had people go, hey, who's editing?
Can I just say, I love your videos. People who, like, I watch them. And I think they're amazing. Like, yeah, I really do. So thank you guys. If you're in this audience or beyond, thanks for making them, because it really is like a memory book for us.
Wait till you see the one for your solo panel. It's like you're a superhero. It's amazing.
Oh, cool.
It's actually, it gave me chills. It's like your whole journey, your whole arc. Clark
You've
arc.
Seen it already?
Yes.
Oh, you get to see everything.
Yeah. Maybe, you know, someone has to. Okay, so, I mean, listen. I don't have specific questions about your relationship on the show, but if you guys want to talk, I know it was a long time ago. Have you met before the show?
No,
before we started working?
Yeah, no, okay. And then, I wanted to ask like a moral question for Clark. Clark obviously had a lot of tough choices. Do you think Clark would have gotten together with Finn if she knew he was with Raven?
At that time, I don't think so, because she had a very strong moral compass.
Right.
Yeah, it's kind of the whole thing.
Which disintegrated over time. But at that time, when she was just a fresh newbie, little lady on the ground? Probably not.
Yeah.
And then there was Raven, and she was like, what the actual F?
Yeah, but
do you remember that scene?
Yeah, totally. But it was, oh, you mean like our scene after?
Yeah.
Sure. I was trying to remember because you said that we know each other before we made the TV show. I was trying to remember the first time we met.
Oh, yeah, I don't actually... Was it at the read-through? Or were you not there yet?
I don't know either.
Oh, yeah.
It was 9 years ago.
Was it nine?
Nearly a decade ago? That's crazy. I've known you a long time.
Yeah, decade.
Lark.
Yeah. Somebody take a button that says, I ship Flark. Please.
Does anybody in this room?
Oh, okay, Amelia!
There we are.
I mean, I'm a
Flark
shipper, obviously, but back in the early
You can be both.
I thought the whole notion of shipping was kind of sort of like...
Exclusive?
Is that
not
No.
You can ship many.
Ship at all.
You ship as in relationship.
Ship it in.
Ship many sails, many seas.
Whomever you like.
Yes.
Seas, okay, yeah. I said the wrong thing. So, yeah.
Good.
Yep. I mean,
what are you going to say?
I should have given you a mic at the beginning. I'm so sorry. I can't repeat all of them.
Good. So far, so good.
It's great. Thank you. Yeah, it was a great kind of conflict that evolved.
Yeah.
Then you became murderers.
That's right.
It's true. That was a real quick turn, I feel like.
Well, we didn't have a whole lot of time.
We didn't. No, you're right.
He loved you so much, he went on that spree looking for you.
Oh, it was my fault. Never.
Yeah, it's in the videos. Like, where's Clara? Where's Clara?
Where is she?
Where's the one who wants his watch or something?
Yeah. Oh, that's right. The watch.
Yeah, the watch.
Yeah. You're really getting in people's faces with him.
Watch.
To be fair, Eliza, over the years, I think there were plenty of people who would go to extremes for Clark Griffin. And like you would for them.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Do you know what, guys? I'm going to rewatch. This whole convention has made me go, all right, I'm going to watch it from the beginning. Have you watched it ever?
Yeah, I'm going to watch it.
You're going to? I think we should. I want to see it now. I mean,
do that later?
Yes. I'm in. I would love that.
Maybe have
oh my god, that's hilarious.
We're not gonna new girl it just yet. but we could. I mean, we could do a podcast. There were like 100 episodes.
I'm gonna watch your superhero.
Real. Video. Yeah. It's tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
I'm gonna start with that.
Okay. That's good. Let's see how we go.
Eliza, how old will Henry be when you show him the 100? 27?
I've been talking to a few moms here. Some have said 8. I think maybe...
Hello, that kid dies, what, Charlotte in episode 4?
Yeah, so like maybe the pilot for an 8-year-old. That's, you know, apart from Jasper dying, that's pretty...
I mean, stabbed against
well,
the tree.
Dying, but
yeah.
Nearly, it looks like he dies. I don't know, like, I feel like 13, 14 is the sweet spot
right.
for that.
Yeah.
But also, like, ugh, mom.
Right.
You're making out with a lot of people.
Oh. You do get naked with that guy in a bunker.
Yeah. That's, you know, that's episode 4.
And then he's going to go, wait, daddy's on the screen, but he's not with you. What's up?
It's episode 4.
Henry's going to be looking at the screen and go, there's daddy, why aren't you, what's happening? He's going to ship the LARP right away.
Daddy's mean.
Yeah. Daddy is mean in season 1. Yeah. That's going to be so interesting. You've got to record that when it happens way in the future. I'm just saying.
We'll think about it.
Oh, that's... That's true.
I would love it. Yeah. I would welcome it. No,
or a flarker.
He's not a bellarker.
Yeah.
What about a marper?
I would also welcome that. Yeah.
Oh, Wingtavia. Okay.
That was good, though. It was a good try.
This is cute.
Yeah, sweet. No, I shot him.
Clark shot him.
That's like it's very familiar.
That's bad.
Clark, I mean, Eliza, no offense, but like, you know, Finn died, Lexa died, Bellamy died. I'm just saying.
Are you sensing a theme?
No, Nyla lived. Nyla lived. So there's one.
Good for her. We're gonna like slipped on by.
It was true.
She did it.
I'm not talking about feelings.
So, but why did you shoot him?
You know, I ask myself the same question every damn day. Why? You know, I don't, honestly, I don't think that she should have. I don't think she would have.
He wasn't, he wasn't doing it.
He was crazy.
It was like he'd gone bad. I'm gonna, like, make this really, like.
He'd gone bad.
It was like he went evil.
Right.
But he was actually on the up and up. He was coming good, and then I just shot him anyway.
To be fair, you were.
Would you agree? Is that
yes.
Kind of how it. Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry,
yeah.
This
thing
came
along. Yes. Clark had a daughter. You want to explain that one?
Oh.
And it's not yours.
And it was Maddie, my adopted child. Yes. A grounded child. From the second apocalypse. Yeah. It's a whole thing. We'll talk about it later.
Her blood is black, super sexy. There's so much you have to catch up on.
Look, I wouldn't say my daughter's blood was sexy. That's weird.
No, you're out of hers. You became a night blood.
I did.
Yeah.
I did.
I don't think he knows what a night blood is.
Night blood? No?
I heard that everyone, there's like, becomes light.
Okay, you're talking about the, like, ascending.
Did you watch Lost instead?
The ascent. Yeah. Yeah, they become like light signatures. Floaty trees.
There were some dancing groups. There were some dancing groups in white light.
Yes.
Right. And Bellamy wore like a white robe for a bit.
Of course.
Yeah. His cult had nice, comfortable jammy robes that were white. Bellamy. So when you shot him in the white, that was real effective. Yeah.
I really saw.
Yeah. There was a book that was left behind. There's a whole reason you shot him, but that's a whole other thing. Okay.
Yeah, we can't even get into that.
We cannot. It's also so too early on day one. I know. Maybe it's by tomorrow afternoon.
When did you get the red hair?
Okay, so that was just after I killed you. Went on a little bit of a tear. Wasn't feeling quite good about that.
Hair just turned red.
Oh, no, berries.
Berries.
Berry dye.
You know how, like,
or
you know.
Berries.
No. It was rubbed into the hair. Yeah.
Was it just from eating so much?
It was. It wasn't Willy Wonka. Yeah.
Tell me about the panther.
Yeah, so I killed a panther.
She jumped out of a tree and killed a panther.
Right.
Yeah.
As you do.
And it was. We had a real panther on set.
It was great. This was episode one of season three.
We had like a real bear one time too, didn't we?
Yep. We did.
I never got to ride a horse, did you?
I did.
Yeah, a lot of problems.
Yeah.
I heard you guys got cars too.
Yeah. I couldn't drive.
Rovers.
Rovers that were very unreliable vehicles. Like, honestly, like, we had to drive them from location to location and they were temperamental.
Drive. You didn't drive.
You shouldn't.
Because somebody just like built it.
Yeah, they let you behind the wheel?
They did.
Someone just got her driver's license finally.
Have you driven? I'm 32, it's nothing to be proud of, but I am. I'm really proud.
Are you driving, actually, driving around LA?
I am.
Are you driving?
Yeah.
You like it?
I love it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Even in LA?
And I think that the fact that I learned to drive there, which is so scary, will make me good at it anywhere.
That's true. Good.
It's good. defensive driving practice for sure.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So here's a question for you two. If Finn had lived, let's say he had a redemptive arc, Lexa didn't have to kill him, you didn't have to kill him, a mercy kill kind of situation.
Nobody survives the feuds.
Nyla. We'll talk later.
Nyla.
Richard's sister played Nyla.
Yeah.
So
if you were to have survived, what were you
going to do? I was just saying, what do you think the future would have been for you, relationship-wise, friendship-wise? Like, what do you think the dynamic would have been?
They probably together and settled down.
Yeah, because, like, all of the conflict would have stopped.
Until the second apocalypse.
Oh, yeah, crime fire.
Right.
Okay, but, like, what about Raven?
Right. Is that your end?
It was Raven who came for Finn more of like this kind of sister
type thing. I think that was kind of like we shot. There was a beautiful episode. You remember when we all were vomiting blood? Do you remember that? You were immune. Episode 9, I think, of season 1. It was like biological warfare. And it was like a bottle episode, and we were all in the dropship the whole time.
Yeah, why did everyone, what was that?
Because, bloody Richard, I mean,
yeah, somebody
Murphy brought it back from the grounders.
Oh.
It was his bargaining chip. Anyway. In that episode, there was a really, like, didn't you end up getting like a, no, that's a different episode, oh my god. I was like, the stab wound? That's 7. Anyway, all amongst this, there's this scene with Raven and you where, like, it's kind of like this beautiful acceptance of the fact that you are not in love with her.
Blown apart romantically.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I was getting at. I'm so sorry. It took a really long time.
Right, and then at some point,
At some point, sorry, Lexa came along and she's all, I'm sorry, Finn who?
Within like 2 episodes of you being dead, she was missing Lexa.
I mean, do you blame her?
Yeah, that's just how it goes. Right?
You were the one who told me that we were getting together.
Right.
Do you remember that? We were in the car on the way to the GBRD, we were going up the mountain, and you were like, to both of us, I think, you were like, did you know you guys are getting together? And we were like, shut up.
Anything at this point? We have a heart out at 5:55.
You look incredible. Not just because you had a baby 5 months ago, but you look incredible.
Thank you.
It's true.
That's so nice. Thank you.
Yeah.
Really, I appreciate it.
Hi.
Hi, Eliza.
Hello.
Nice to see you again. And Tom.
Oh, hi.
Hi. Oh God, I hate this mic. Okay. So if there was a love triangle with Bellamy and Finn and Clark, who do you think she would choose?
Ooh. Oh my God. Yeah, Lexa. It's a square. That is so tricky. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with Lexa.
Also, can I get you to say, I bear it so they don't have to?
I bear it so they don't have to.
Oh.
Nice. Thank you so much.
I haven't done that accent in a really long time. I heard that was it. Maury.
Hi. I was just wondering what your favorite scene was to film together.
Oh.
I like that swimming scene you did really early on.
That was freezing.
Yeah.
But
so
it was fun. It was. It was the first time I think that this is like episode 3, I think, of season 1.
Great.
It was early. Yeah. And Tom and I had to get in a glacier-fed lake or pond, dam. What do you call it?
It might have been a dam pond.
A dam pond. So we, And Tom had to be the one who was like, I'm getting in, I don't care, I'm a rebel. But he was, his teeth were chattering so bad. He was like, Clark, get in. And we had to spend a lot of time trying to get you to not do that.
I don't remember that much.
You don't remember?
I remember going to this movie, but...
It was fun, though.
Well, one of the really fun things about the show, at least when I was working on it, I don't know what happened after you guys got cars, but when I was working on it, we were, like, outside all the time, like, in this actual beautiful landscape.
Beautiful, yeah.
In the trees and in the water. And,
like, it was so easy to be immersed in the world, because we had everything at our fingertips. We had, like, it felt like untouched earth, which was incredible.
Just lie down on the moss and go to sleep.
Yeah, yeah. I have pictures of you sleeping in the grass.
I have pictures of you sleeping.
Oh, okay. You do? Is that on your flip phone from like back in the day?
2013?
That one, yeah. Mm-hmm. Is that the scene where he splashes you and you're like...
Yes, that
it's
one.
A very, that was memed and gift to no end.
Yeah. Was it?
Oh, yeah, the exasperation.
I need to get back in touch. I need to see these.
We'll send all of them to you.
Okay, yes. Cool.
With the gifts
and the memes. I don't know what they, is it memes?
Memes.
What? Memes. Memes.
With the Australian accent, yes.
Memes.
Hi guys. Back to kind of your point about having creepy, weird pictures of each other on your phones.
There was a video that was circulating a long time ago that Thomas, I think, made, either on a camera or on a phone, and it was of the cast holding random pieces of fruit. Do you remember that?
That's...
And can you explain the story behind that, please?
Yeah, you can. That was brilliant. I still don't understand it, but it was beautiful. So Tom, he's a mysterious man. And in his spare time, he was buttering up the cameraman and our DP. And he was, who's a wonderful man, and he was saying, can we just get some extra footage of different people holding different pieces of fruit? I don't know why, and I'll never understand why. I'm not sure that you do, but maybe you do.
Why?
Yeah, why?
Well,
what was there anything symbolic, or you just thought, I would
I just
like
thought
to.
That we had, you know, as much as we were working, we were there, like, downtime, like flipping a camera or like set up where you have all this amazing equipment and stuff, just sort of like sit. So we use the cameras that we film the show on to film this other stuff, like in between, and what we have around was like fruit. Like,
oh, from craft services.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then we ran out of stuff, so it was like the same old banana or whatever. So I said,
yeah, I think I held a mango at one point.
Yeah, and then after a while we had to go.
More exotic.
You know, it was a bit of an experiment.
It was really cool though.
Huge success.
Huge.
Well, it's memorable. People remember it.
I've only seen little snippets of it. I haven't seen your edit of it. Would you share it? I would love to see it.
We'll tweet it out on the Con Again account.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. I would like to see it.
Thanks, guys.
Fruit, directed by Thomas McDonald.
Is it called Fruit? Does it have a name? What is the name?
Hello, I'm Gail from Salem, Mass. And I just want to know what your favorite episode is out of all the seasons. You two.
Yes,
do you have a favorite?
Yes, I do. Yeah. My favorite is episode 8 of season 1.
Really?
I have a lot of favorites. But it's the one I go back to. I just thought it was so cool. Everyone is so brilliant. It was the first time that we saw people, because the whole cast was on hallucinogens, basically. Well, the characters, not the cast.
Allegedly.
But it was just, and I think one of my favorite scenes is Chris Larkin. Do you remember this? Coming into the tent with
and
Raven,
sure.
And he's like, something about the moon?
Yeah. Yeah, what does he say about the moon? A good line.
It's a great line. Does anyone?
I can't change the tide if the moon doesn't cooperate.
I can't change the tide if the moon doesn't corroborate. It was so good. That is one of my favorite scenes of the entire series.
Yeah, it's funny. It feels kind of like old school somehow. Yeah.
It is. Yeah.
What did they have you eat in place of actual drugs? Like, did they just give you a gummy bear or what?
It was pistachios.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
Did you have a favorite scene?
I don't think about that one. Cool. That's a good idea. Like the idea that you have like an episode devoted to one very specific weird idea.
Yes. I think that was the only one that was just like super random and worked really well.
Okay.
So I have two questions for you guys. The first one is for both of you. So from an acting standpoint, I thought you guys did wonderful in the scene where you killed him, from an acting standpoint. And I was curious, like, did you guys have to do any prep work for that or anything to kind of get into that headspace? Because it was obviously an emotional scene.
We had a lot of time. That was a 15-hour day or something, and it was all night. So like we started late and we finished it like the sun was coming up when we finished.
Yeah.
And it was raining the whole time.
Kind of intense.
It was really intense because we had 200 extras.
Yeah.
We had like fire torches. This whole there was the whole thing going on at the Arcadia.
Yeah.
And there was our stuff in the grounded camp as well. It was a huge production. Like that whole day was massive, and we had to get it done in that one night.
Yeah.
So we didn't do anything to prepare.
No, we never like rehearsed the scene. We just sort of did it.
We just did it, yeah. But we had a lot of time to kind of do it. We were standing around a while because they had to shoot the whole Arcadia bit.
But another thing is that built into, I don't know if this is your experience, but when you work on a character for like. TV, you have an opportunity to like really build something out of a longer period. It's kind of like gives you a leg up on heavier scene like that because it's built into your character. You have like more access quicker to your like emotional stuff just by like looking at a person you have this built in history. So you can.
It's very true.
You get to it.
Yeah, we got to it.
And then my second question would be, I know that Clexa like meant a lot to a lot of people, so I just was wondering what it was like for you to work with Alicia.
I love Alicia. She's and you worked with Alicia before any of us did.
Yeah.
You guys did a movie together.
Yeah, with Shannon Cook.
No.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah,
did you guys know this?
No.
Well, this morning.
Joe didn't.
I haven't seen the movie, sorry.
Oh my god, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, so yes. Anyway, I didn't know Shannon was in.
She's great.
She is great.
She's definitely
scary. Yes. She, she's one of my favorite people. Amazing to work with. So genuine, so kind. And just the real deal. Like, she's the sort of person that walks into a room and you go, that's a star. Like, it's just the way it is. She's amazing.
I have a question for Thomas. So season one Finn is very much a pacifist, trying to find a way to solve a problem without violence. Season two Finn, not so much. Did you ever find out if there was a reason why that shit occurred, or did the writers just do what the writers wanted to do?
Yeah, there's like a couple answers. We decided that the character was going to die, Finn.
Really?
We decided that was going to happen before having a plan about how to do it. So it was like there was the space, and then it was the goal was to figure out a way that we could kill the character but not have it be egregious insofar as the character was still such a good guy, and people would think, well, he didn't deserve this. I think it was a different sort of phase of the show. I think it, later on, it sort of, that there was like a logic to that. So the character that had started as this pacifist, it was like, what could we do to make this person like so bad that they kind of like deserve to be killed? So like shooting a village full of innocent people seemed like it would do that.
That'll do it.
Yeah, but that's sort of like a practical kind of like reason. The details, I don't know.
very interesting. Thank you.
All right, so not to, as in not to give you some actual parenting advice, but speaking as a once 13-year-old boy, maybe don't show your 13-year-old son the Clark Finn sex scene.
Yeah, no. I plan to fast forward or...
There's some great fruit from that day.
Do you know that's my favorite fruit day?
Yeah.
That's really nice. My mom was on set that day.
Yeah.
I was like, Mom, you chose a really weird day to come in. She was like, I really like Thomas, but I couldn't watch the stuff that you were doing. But I liked the fruit. She did. She was like, what is he?
I think it was a nectarine.
Was it a nectarine?
Yeah.
My actual question.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. That was great. My actual question is, you know, the scene where Clark Mercy kills Finn is obviously one of the most seminal moments in the whole show, and I think, I mean, I won't speak for myself, it's one of the very best moments in the whole show, and the performances are amazing. You know, there's a part where, right before Clark kills him, she tells Finn that she loves him. So I always viewed it as open to interpretation of, is she telling Finn this because she's killing him and she knows he loves her and she wants to give him some nice moment at the end? Or did she love him?
How did you play it?
How did you receive it? She loved him.
No hesitation. She absolutely loved him. Oh, that's the way I played it. Unless I got it completely wrong.
So it's like they just bring into it as, you know, an audience member. But no, I could see it going any number of ways. Okay, cool. All right, thank you.
You got her.
Speaking of Clark killing Finn,
of the
many, many, many deaths that Clark had her hands on, which for you was the hardest to execute?
Ooh. The hardest death?
Yeah. What, like...
I know, off the top of my head, and you probably know this, you can probably guess, it was not a lead character or a, you know, major storyline, it was this one guy.
What?
Dave.
Close your ears, Thomas.
Okay, so it's not you. it was just these, she was so sinister in this moment where she slit this guy's throat and just made her look at him while he died. Do you remember that? It was this...
It's cool.
It was horrific. Right. So it was this grounder. It was really, really horrible. I think it was a turning point for Clark. And that was one of the days where I had to go home and be like, I'm not Clark, I'm a good person.
Well, you had practice with mercy killing because of Adam, too.
Oh, yes, very early on.
Mm-hmm. Poor Finn.
Reese Ward. What a guy.
Yeah, right.
What a guy.
That's funny. Did you have a lot of times where you went, oh, I'm not like, well, why is this so easy?
Yeah. No, not the easy part. No, more the, like, I'm not... You know, like I didn't really kill anyone today, sort of thing. It's a real thing though, you like, because you dream about it. You're in that world for like 15 hours a day, and it gets in, you know, psyche a little bit. So you have to kind of just go, no, this is make believe. We're making television, and it's not real.
I would say the only thing you have in common with Clark Griffin is your deep loyalty. You are a very loyal person.
Resilience.
Thank you, Joe. Mm-hmm.
It's true.
And resilient.
Question for Thomas as well. Being that you were only on the show for the beginning, how does it feel to come back to, you know, like a convention like this all these years later and relive all these memories?
It's cool. It was really cool to watch that video. but really, it's just fun to see, like, we're like old friends, so it's cool. Like, we haven't seen each other.
I was so excited to see you.
But, you know, there's also like a whole bunch of this show that I... No, that's okay. I'm learning a lot too about what all happened. Cars
happened.
Yeah. It's pretty cool.
Thank you, bud.
Yeah. I know you don't know me. My name's Troy.
Of course we know. Well, Tom might not know you. You know you guys are friends now, surely.
So, and maybe a little bit different direction. If you could rewrite or redo a particular scene or episode, what would it be?
Season, I'm going to go earlier. I'm going to say season 3, episode 7.
Thank you. Remind me what's
what is that?
No, that's an excellent answer.
Okay.
That's the only answer.
Yeah, I think Lex's death was not great.
Right.
And you've probably heard about this.
That's the one where she
yeah. I would like
stray bullet.
Like I feel like so many people were really deeply affected by that. I would like to rewrite that for them. Yeah. How about you?
Oh, right. Let's see. It's hard to say. I mean, you know, that weird episode where I came back haunted as a ghost.
That was weird, for sure.
Maybe you could have done like 2 or 3 more of those.
Yeah, there had been like an ongoing thing, and it wasn't, but your day rate was probably too high.
Just standing over there in the trees.
Just with someone standing in the trees, it was like, it was expensive.
That's gotta be one of the weirder acting jobs that I've done. Like,
that was not...
Because I was in a lot of it, but I wasn't doing anything.
And the worst part was, yeah, I think you nailed it. It didn't continue. It was just one isolated episode.
Haunting.
Would you say 3?
I said 3. Right,
because he looked at the top.
Oh my god, wow. I need to rewatch this. All I remember from that episode was Tom being weird, just like staying all the time. And just having to be like, what? With my eyes. Yeah, that's a good answer. What would you have changed? How would you have done it differently?
Well, that's a whole other thing.
We can talk about it later.
You would add fruit.
Yeah, for a start, yeah. We'll talk later.
Yeah.
Hi, my name's Danielle. So you actually kind of addressed one of my questions just now. So one of two is, if Finn ate the fruit as well as the nuts, what would he have seen? Would he have
seen? Yeah, you were sober.
The pistachios?
Yeah.
It's the Joby nut, yes.
Sorry. Right. What were you seeing?
My dad.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Would have been...
You know, sometimes we get back, and, like, I would talk to some of the writers about, like, backstory of these characters, you know, because that's what you do sometimes as an actor, is, like, build, like, character by thinking about their history and stuff. And one of the funniest conversations I had with these guys was about, like, Finn's name. Because, like, Finn sometimes is short for, like, a longer name, like, Phineas. Or
Findle.
Findle. But I thought his name was Finbar.
Oh, I remember that. Vaguely remember this.
Yeah, and they said, well,
debate.
No. And I said, well.
Well, yeah, now
well,
it
I
is.
And
they
said it wasn't, so it kind of is, right? That doesn't answer.
How did you feel about Collins?
Collins, that's a good name.
Okay.
What are you doing?
This has such a final panel vibe for the day.
I'm sorry. Back to your question.
What do you mean? Is that good?
I don't know. I just don't feel like Finn Collins suits that character. I don't know why.
Finn Bar Collins sounds like a
Finn
cocktail.
Bar Collins.
It's a cocktail. Like, you know.
It does sound like it.
Well, it's just because of a Tom Collins.
Exactly.
Anyway.
So my second question is, I guess, if Finn could talk during that ghost episode, what do you think he would have said to her? And was it a hallucination on Clark's part because she was so tired? Because you were literally, I don't think you slept after you killed him.
Yeah.
But no. the exhaustion and also
sleep
the
deprivation.
Guilt.
Yeah.
And the guilt.
Because.
So you don't think that Finn was really there just staring? Like
well,
a weirdo?
Did any kind of like more like supernatural type stuff like that happen later on in the part?
Not really.
Raven got like supernaturally possessed, you know.
Well, yeah, but there was nothing like ghostly, like.
No, but
freaking Lexa came back as a god, so like...
Well, yes, yeah, yes.
Spoiler alert. Body.
Yeah, never mind. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
We have 4 minutes.
Well, that's good, thanks. My question was actually already asked and answered, because I was going to ask, you know, Thomas, how it felt to kind of revisit this whole world after so many years. So instead, I just will say, I haven't watched seasons 1 and 2 for a very, very long time, but I was watching them recently in preparation to like come to the con, and I was watching them when I found out you were coming to the con, and I got so excited that you were coming, because I was like remembering
so cool.
How like sweet and pure those early days were, and how sweet,
right.
How sweet that was. So, I will just say thank you so much for coming, because I was like so excited to be able to hear your perspectives on the characters and the world and everything, so.
Thanks for having me.
I second that.
Yeah.
I second that. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Last question, Tom. Mr. Lee.
Well, I really want to kind of have something I want to say. I do have a question for Thomas, but I had to tell somebody. The 100 is trending number one on Twitter right now.
Yeah.
And it's all because of the post that you guys are tagging.
Eliza's been trending all day.
Yeah, I don't think that's ever happened at a con again that the 100 was trending number one. So.
That's so cool.
And Heather caught Jason Rothenberg watched one of our live broadcasts earlier.
No comment.
And. All right.
Bellamy and Eliza are trending. Not Bob, just Bellamy.
Yeah.
That's his name.
And my question for Thomas is...
Tom to Tom.
What, yeah, I know, I was like, I like this guy already. His name's Thomas. So I told him last night, Thomas, I'm Thomas. What do you think so far about this event? Because it's different in a great way. So I'm very curious what your first impressions are.
It does feel a little bit different. And it feels very smooth and fun and cool. It's like everyone's so nice, and you know, a combination of just being like automatically pretty excited to be back after so long to talk about stuff. But like, yeah, thanks for having me. What a cool thing.
Well, a lot of people excited you're here, and we're glad you're here. And if we have another one, which hopefully we'll consider, you'll get a chance to come back. So.
Well, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thank you.
And thank you both. Before we go, just because I want to clarify, I do not want the internet to kill me. When I said that's the only correct response, that there's two correct responses to rewriting. You would rewrite Bellamy and Lexa's death and make them either different or not happen, and not just one.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, that, yeah, that one was a given, but yeah. And I've talked about that one before, but yeah.
Yes, I want to make sure.
And Maddie, I mean, no, well, I mean, she should.
She shouldn't have died.
She shouldn't have died.
Maybe you should have taken the book, I'm just saying.
But... John, you just like nailed it on the head again. Yeah, I mean, why didn't she take the book?
The whole point. You're gonna take the book and
it was an oversight on all of our parts, and I can't just blame.
I'm not gonna say it's an oversight on your part.
No, I should have gone. Why? Hey, guys.
Right.
You know, I should have.
Yeah.
And for that, I apologize.
That's okay. Thomas will catch up someday. Watch.
Thomas, we're gonna have a big chat after this, and
yes.
I'm gonna catch you up to everything.
Yeah. By the way, Clark gets a dog and a daughter. It's a whole thing.
Oh yeah, there's a dog.
There's a dog.
Really?
Yeah, a golden retriever.
For as a pet.
His name is Picasso.
And it's not a robot. It's an actual
he
dog.
He was actually a girl in real life.
And it's the only dog left.
On Earth.
Yes.
Ever.
Yeah.
Dogs.
Makes sense.
I'm gonna show you some stuff.
Yeah.
We're gonna YouTube.
Well, we have to clear the room because they're gonna prepare for
thank
the party.
You guys
thank you, Alana and Thomas.